Hi, I'm Ufuma Ogaga from Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create and use a custom field to track the tax classification status of your service vendors in QuickBooks Online Advanced. Let's get started. In my QuickBooks Online Advanced file, I am going to click the gear icon and select custom fields under the list column. Click add field and select vendor info. Here I will add my vendor name as tax entity type W-9 and select the drop-down list option. I'm going to leave the inactive box checked and the use on expense forms box unchecked. Here's a copy of a W-9 form. My drop-down options are going to mirror question number 3 on the W-9 form. Going back to QuickBooks Online Advanced, I will add up to 7 lines. I'm going to add a non-service provider as my first option and add request W-9 form as my second option. Then continue with the process of adding all of the other W-9 form federal tax classifications. You will notice that I have combined the S corporation and the C corporation as one line, since most of the time corporations do not receive a 1099 unless if they are legal service providers. So I'm going to click save to exit out of this screen. Let's go back to the vendor center to apply the new custom field to my service vendors. So I'm going to find a service vendor and click edit on the vendor profile. Scroll down and select the tax entity type from the drop-down menu. Then click save. I'll repeat this process for all of my service vendors. One thing I would love to see is the option to use the batch action feature to apply custom fields to all of my existing vendors without having to click into the individual profiles. Help me submit feedback to Intuit to add this capability by clicking on the gear icon and selecting feedback. Now let's look at how the tax entity type custom field shows up on the vendor contact list report. So click on reports, search for the vendor contact list, and run the report. To see my custom field, I'll click on the customize button. Under rows and columns, I'll scroll down to select the tax entity type field, tax ID, track 1099, and email address. Then I'm going to reorder the layout of my columns and click Run Report once done. So here is the vendor contact list report. I can either export this to Excel or to Google Sheets, or I can save this report to use and run on a monthly or quarterly basis to copy the details I need to send out W-9 form requests to vendors using a third-party 1099 system or email my clients to follow up with their vendors. That is my quick tip to keep track of the tax classification status of your service vendors in QuickBooks Online Advanced to make your 1099 preparation process easier. Comment below and let me know what other ways you are using custom fields in QuickBooks Online Advanced.